Good morning, everyone. I'm Mayor John Noak, and I just want to welcome you to the Village of Romeoville's Memorial Day program. This year, we moved it into over here just a way of kind of logistics today. Because of the weather we've been having the last few weeks and the wet conditions on the site over at the Memorial Park. We do invite you, though, however, after the program, if you'd like to go over there, please just try and stay on the concrete, the paver surfaces. The site's a little wet, so we don't want to do any damage to it. Obviously, we really encourage everyone, not only on days like today, but throughout the year, to utilize that facility in remembrance of those who have served us. So we want to keep it set up the way it is. Unfortunately, due to the wet conditions, we weren't able to go over there today. But I do welcome you. And I'm so glad that we have such a large crowd out here today. We've been able to come over here to this fire station previously when weather conditions were a little challenging. And it's nice to have this facility and for the fire department to host us over here. And they do such a wonderful job for us. So with that, we're going to try and abbreviate the program a little bit. So you do have the opportunity to go over to the Memorial Park and pay respects and visit over there as well. As I said, please try and utilize the concrete areas and the paver surfaces for that. With that, I will turn over to... Now, I'd like to invite Pastor Christopher Hudson, one of our chaplains for the Village of Romeoville Fire and Police, to join us or lead us in the opening prayer. Please.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. This Memorial Day that gives us the opportunity to celebrate the sacrifice of brave men and women who have answered the call to serve this country. Father, we pray that all have a true understanding of what this day truly represents. The bravery, the dedication, the selflessness and patriotism of men and women who for our freedoms that we enjoy every day paid the ultimate sacrifice with their lives so that we can live free. We thank you, Lord, for every branch of service, and we pray that you bless this memorial service to bring honor to all who have served and have laid their lives down so that we can live free. In Jesus' name, amen.
Before I introduce our guest speaker, I want to take a quick moment and introduce some of the officials that are here with us today. And I'm going to get to the one that just joined us in a moment. First of all, I want to, and please be seated. And I want to introduce Trustee Linda Pallmeyer, our clerk, Dr. Bernice Holloway, our Trustee Brian Clancy, Trustee Dave Richards, from the DuPage Township Tax Collector, Gary Hoffman, and from the Valley View School Board, Victor Zach. And I'm actually going to, now that he was able to join us, and I know he's got a busy schedule today, so we're going to give him a quick moment before our speaker that's on our program today and introduce Congressman Lipinski, who would like to say a couple of words.
Thank you very much. I apologize for being a little late. This is the number two of seven events that I'm doing today. But it really is, I'm so happy that I represent a district where so many people understand what the real meaning of Memorial Day is. It's not just the beginning of the summer. It's where we remember and thank all those who died for our freedom. So I want to thank Mayor Noak, the village of Romeoville, the fire department, thank all of you for being here today, especially all of our veterans who are here. You know, about two weeks ago, I had the opportunity to be at a dinner where famed historian David McCullough spoke. And he talked about the importance of knowing, remembering history. He said it's so important because knowing history gives us two things. First, empathy. Understanding what people before us went through, exactly what they did, how hard things were for them, for all the people who paved the way for us to be where we are today. It certainly is true of all of our veterans, especially those who died serving us and serving freedom. Hopefully you've had the chance to, you know, see some of the movies, you know, the movies made about D-Day, Saving Private Ryan, The Longest Day, Band of Brothers, to just give you a sense of what all of those largely men, but men and women went through as we come up on the 75th anniversary of D-Day. 5 years ago, I had the honor of being there for the 70th anniversary of D-Day. And just to be there where that, you know, invasion took place and to see the terrain that they encountered really brought to life those things that I heard about, saw about movies, and heard from some of the survivors there. The second thing history gives us is gratitude. It reminds us to be thankful to all those who've done so much for us. And there's no one has done more for us than those who have given their lives for us, for our country and our freedom. And in that also their families. So on this Memorial Day, please remember what it's all about. Remember all of those throughout our history who have fought for our nation, especially those who have died for our nation, for our freedom, for the freedom of others around the world. Be thankful, be grateful for what they have done. And please also remember and pray for those who are out there today serving us still, all around the world. They make it possible for us to live in the freedom that we so much enjoy today. And remember when those who are away, please take care of their families and take care of them when they return. So I ask you to do that today. And today especially, God bless our veterans. God bless all of you, and God bless the United States of America. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Today, our guest speaker is Mark Bowman, Commander Sergeant Major, retired of the Illinois Army National Guard. If you would please join me.
Morning, everybody. My name is Commander Sergeant Major Mark Bowman, retired. I grew up in Downers Grove. I live in Plainfield now. And I served almost 37 years in the Army, active duty and National Guard. Thank you. I'm humbled and deeply honored to be here today. I talked to my fellow veterans and the families that have fallen. There are many pictures that come to mind, so just take a moment and imagine. A table set and it's time to eat. Two kids sit next to each other and gaze across the table as their mom sits down and asks the boy to say grace. Looking at all the love surrounding them at the table, the kids smile to each other and they knew that they're lucky. As the boy looked at the empty chair by his mother, though, he thought, I'm lucky to have such a great dad. He put on his Army uniform, stood up for what he knew was right, so that we could all enjoy this food and life that we have today. As the young boy looked at the empty chair, he smiled and bowed his head. He knew his dad was there beside him, even just in spirit. This is a familiar experience for veterans and the families that have fallen, our true heroes. We are here today to recognize all the veterans, especially those that I know, that have made the ultimate sacrifice since 9/11. Nearly 7,000 service members have lost their lives in Iraq and Afghanistan and Syria. 252 of those troops are from the state of Illinois. 33 soldiers and one airman were part of the Illinois National Guard. 18 of those casualties were part of the mobilization of the 33rd Infantry Brigade Combat Team in 08-09, and those are mine. These are soldiers that dedicated their lives for our freedom, and we will never forget their sacrifice. Forever, these soldiers and their families will be part of our military family. General Norman Schwarzkopf once said, they didn't go to war, they didn't want to leave their families, and when their country asked them to, they did because they knew it was the right thing to do. This comment was made decades after World War II, when 19,000 American soldiers died in the Battle of the Bulge in the winter of 1944, or the 13,000 soldiers, Marines, and Navy personnel who died taking Okinawa in the Pacific in 1945. The Americans persevered. Their courage and sacrifice knew no bounds. The same holds true today with conflicts that keep going on in Iraq, Syria, Afghanistan, and other places. Our troops are always ready to defend the flag and what it stands for. You think about these men and women, young men and women, in uniform, and think of the ones who are buried in the cemeteries here at home and throughout the world, and we thank all of them for their sacrifice and their family sacrifice, which you don't think of normally. More than 200 soldiers right now, and airmen from Illinois National Guard, the Air Guard, and the Army Guard, aren't home with their families today. They're serving overseas. Most are in Iraq and Afghanistan still. We have two infantry battalions going to Afghanistan very soon this year. More than 13,000 soldiers in the Illinois Army Guard have deployed multiple times since 9/11. And more than 12,000 airmen in the Illinois Air Guard have deployed multiple times in support of various missions around the globe. And they all sacrifice every day. Thanks to these young men and women and to every American veteran, we are granted freedom and liberty from oppression. But let us not forget the families affected who have loaned us their service member. But we also owe them the debt of gratitude, whether it be shouldering the burden of multiple deployments, raising their young children with only one service member, with one service member gone, and losing their loved one in the process. Our families are all true heroes. And I've also had many, many families that the wives and the husbands are both in the military, and they both deployed together. Without their continued support, our military cannot continue to be the best the world has to offer. Think of the family we talked about earlier enjoying that meal with the vacant chair at the table. That soldier gave his life or her life for our freedom, but the family continues to feel the void every day. The pain may subside, but it'll never go away. This could have been the scene at a dinner for somebody who was very close to me, Sergeant Simone Robinson, who is from Robbins, Illinois. She left behind a little girl, Nazia, who's now 13 years old. She died of her wounds over 10 years ago, this year. That little girl's a teenager now, growing up without her mom. But Sergeant Simone was a soldier, a leader, a sergeant, and doing her job. Today and throughout the year, let us all remember how fortunate we are to live in this nation where so many have given so much. Before I stop, just this day is personal to me, more personal than I ever thought it would be. I served a long time in the Army before I got to combat. I had over 25 years in the Army before I went to Afghanistan the first time in 05, and then, of course, with the BCT, the brigade, in 809, when we took all those casualties. Our task force had 9,000 people. We were training the Afghan Army and the Afghan police, and we lost 40 people that year in 809. 40 people. And I had 90 casualties. What caught me off guard was that when all the wounded I had that year, especially that summer of 09, I was able to get to Bagram or Kandahar before they were evacuated to Germany. And I sat down with a lot of my wounded and I talked to them. And it doesn't matter where they came from, what state they came from, because we had multiple states in the task force, they always told me the same thing. Sergeant Major, don't send me home. Don't send me home. I can do this. I can get back in the fight. They didn't want to leave the team. These are the kids that grow up down your street and join the Guard, join the Army to get money for college. But they become soldiers and airmen in the process. And they're in the fight and they're part of the team. They didn't want to go home. They wanted to stay with their friends. Or they'd ask me, how is so-and-so doing? They never care about what shape they're in. They're worried about their buddies. Again and again and again. Me and my boss, the task force commander, General Huber, who's from Illinois as well, we told ourselves that when we get back to Illinois, we're going to go to every family's home of the people that we lost and sit down with the family and talk about the member that we didn't bring back home. And we did that across the state. You don't know how big Illinois is until you get out and start driving this state. It's a big state. And once again, we sat down with the families, and they asked me two questions. Number one, they always asked me how their daughter or their son or their spouse, how they died. And then every family asked me and General Huber, but how are you guys doing? How are you doing? After all that, they were concerned about our well-being. Once again, it's the people in our community that we take for granted. These families, these young men and women that joined the Army or the services and put their uniform on, amazing people. And that's the people that we're raising right here. Thank you.
Thank you. Next, we will have the presentation of the wreaths. First wreath that will be presented today will be from American Legion Post 52. The next presentation will be from the American Legion Women's Auxiliary Unit 52. The next wreath presentation will be from the Citizens Police Academy alumni of Romeoville. Our next presentation will be from the Grand Haven Veterans Club. Next will be the Hampton Park Social Club. The next wreath will be from the Romeoville Area Historical Society. The next organization presenting a wreath will be the Romeoville Fire Auxiliary. Next, we will have the Romeoville Veterans Commission. And our final wreath will be presented by the Village of Romeoville. Now I'd like everyone to join me in a moment of silence and observation of all past, present, and fallen men and women who have fought or are fighting for our country. Please join me. Rise and join me in a moment of silence.
Thank you.
Now I'd like to welcome up Pastor Hudson once again to lead us in a closing prayer.
Heavenly Father, we just thank you today. Lord, we can never imagine the sacrifice, Lord. But Father, we thank you for every man and woman, Lord, that has given their life for this country. Father, we just want to honor them today, Lord. We don't want to take for granted what they gave for us, Lord, so that we can live free, God. And we just say thank you, Lord. We worship you, Father. And Lord, right now we pray for those who are still serving, Lord, as they stand serving to defend us, Lord, and keep us free, Lord. We pray that you defend them, Lord, that you keep them protected, that you be a wedge of protection around them, God. Bring them home safely, oh God. We just thank you today. And Lord, we pray right now, wherever there's any despair, any depression, Lord, anything that they're dealing with, God, that you fill them with your peace and you fill them with your joy, that you wrap your loving arms around them, God, and let them know that they are not alone. That even though we can't be there with them physically, that we are here with them spiritually, Lord, and we're praying for them and we're standing with them, Lord, and we're honoring their sacrifice. We're honoring what they're giving for this country. And Lord, we thank you today and we give you glory and honor, for we know that you have them in your hands. And Father, we thank you for this Memorial Day. We thank you for those who have gone before. We thank you for our veterans right now, and we thank you for those who are serving presently. And we pray, God, that you keep their families right now, God. Father, for those families who have lost family members to wars, Lord, we pray right now that you fill them with a peace to let them understand that they did not die in vain. That, Lord, that they gave their lives to an honorable cause. They gave their lives so that this country can continue to enjoy the freedoms and liberties that we still enjoy today. So, Father, we stand proudly for our veterans. And we thank you for each and every man and woman. We thank you for every branch that's represented. And Lord, we pray right now that they will continue to stand with courage, discipline, and patriotism, brotherhood, and in love. And it's in your Son Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Please be seated for a moment. As we close, I want to once again thank everybody for joining us here today for our Romeoville Memorial Day ceremony. And I want to thank many of the groups that have been here with us today, the Romeoville High School Marine Junior ROTC, Romeoville High School Band. I want to thank Pastor Hudson. I want to thank our speakers, Congressman Lipinski, Command Sergeant Major Bowman. I want to thank all the organizations that made presentations today. Most of all, I want to thank those that have served us and those we've lost serving us. You know, as a mayor, I am honored to work with veterans every day. You can just see it in the organizations that walked up here and did presentation of wreaths. I don't think there's a single one that didn't have a veteran or family member as part of those organizations. They continue to serve us. Their families continue to serve us. And I'm honored to be a part of a community that understands what that service has meant and continues to mean to us in every day. And we're so fortunate to have so many people that care for those families, care for those veterans, and remember those who have served us. And it is my honor to continue to serve those that feel that way. I'm also honored to be the son of a veteran, a disabled veteran that served this country. It reminds me every day about what that service means. I'm also honored to be a father and to have a 7-year-old that takes the time to understand and want to learn the history. You know, we have a book that we were reading our 7-year-old the other day about D-Day. And it's kind of amazing to think about teaching a 7-year-old about D-Day. And I love the fact that we have history that is works for children of that age. It's never too early to teach a child about service and commitment. And I tell you, very proud to be father of a kid that way. So as we're here today and we think about those that we've lost, we still have, I'm also reminded about all the comments we've heard about families We remember those that have served us and allow us to be here, for our country to continue to thrive, for our state, for our communities, and for our families. But let's remember those families that have lost. Maybe they're not here with us today. Maybe they can't be here for some reason, but they're there. And we want them to know, even if they can't come out to our memorial, they can't join us in an event, if it's at home in those moments that they reflect, that our hearts are with them and that we care about them. So we want to send them that message. We want to, any opportunity we get, please, throughout the year, reach out. Let them know how much the service of their loved ones have meant, how much that they continue to mean to all of us. And let's remember that those who served us and gave their lives, they gave it for all of us, that we have a commitment and a duty to move forward, to remember them, to remember their families, and to do the best we can as a country, as a state, and as a community, and as people. I'm honored to be here with you today. I'm honored to remember them. I ask you again, if you want, please reflect in our Memorial Park. Remember those who have served us, not only today, but throughout the year and into the future. Thank you, and that concludes our program. Thank you.